I'm forgiven. So repentance is not connected always to guilt.
所以悔改不是都是与这个罪恶感连接的。
没有，我是觉得这个问题有点难解释，因为那个西方教会的传统那个强调是你有罪，你得罪了人家，上帝非常的生气。非常的神奇，所以你要悔改。
Yes.
这是个之前不存在的关系。
What you are saying is you are very, very accurate. Okay. But for the first church and till today, as you know, we know, in the Orthodox Church, the joy is a disease. It's not that I break a law, and so I go to the court, I pay, I finish.
所以从初代教会，最少的宗正教是这样子。就是悔改，就是说你知道错了，你改变，而不是说你去那法庭，人家说哦你做错，付了罚金你就走了，可是你没有改变。
So because it is medical, the church is tries to cure. Of course, in your life you must live a life of repentance, because always you will discover you are not so perfect as you think. So you have always to improve.
那在东正教来讲，这个悔改就是你发现你有罪，这个罪就是一个病，那你这个病得到医治，你这个得到医好了。
And this is why you take even vitamins. From one point of view, it's medicine. I mean, because this helps you, you know, to clean your body, and you can make it more clean, and you can make your heart work better. And the more you try to have exercise, this is the life of repentance.
那这个悔改就是知道你这个有病，你知道你不是一个很完美的人，那你要改就是来接受医疗，就好像你可能要让你身体更好，你可能会吃一些维他命，那也许这样子你觉得还不够，你可能还要加上这个运动。
So this is the repentance. If this you translate, not translate, you put it in the spiritual life, okay, this is the life of repentance, especially a monkIt's living a life of repentance. Say, repent of what? I did not do anything.
那个悔改哈，其实是跟属灵的生命连接的。那一个修士的话，他整个生命就是在这悔改。你可能会说，那他悔改什么？他又没做错什么事？那就是跟他的生命、灵性的生命连接。
The more you know God, the more you know how infinite love is God, and the more you understand.